Hi, I'm Tony Fleming, and this is Fleming's Ultimate Garage.
This particular car right here may be one of the rarest cars we've ever had. And you say, wow, Tone, that's an SVO Mustang, which is a super cool car to begin with, but how could it be so rare? You say, how can it be so rare? Is that what you're saying to me right now? Is that what you're saying? You're coming at me? Anyway, the reason why I say this is because we have so much documentation to support exactly what this vehicle is. So Hertz Rent-A-Car did lots of projects with Ford in the 60s, other projects along the way, ordered 60 of these cars. Now keep in mind that these SVOs, if you wanted to go racing, you would buy this car over the GT Mustang because this came with all the great bits in it. So Ford wanted to race these cars. They were required to sell them to the public, and that's how this potentially could be in your hands. Now, keep in mind that of the 60 cars that were ordered, only 10 of them came in this color. Only 10 came in this color, and in the registry, this has a specific registry because of its rarity, only 4 are left in existence. You're like, wow, man, that is some kind of cool. That's what I said when I heard it. I said, wow, that is some kind of cool. But anyway, I'll show you the Marty report that we have too, which documents the authenticity of the English that I'm telling you right now, because that's where I got it from. And we'll take a walk around and you'll see some of the big components. Now, for instance, like we start with wheels and tires, right? These were 16-inch wheels, where on the GTs, you or an LX, you would have got a smaller wheel and tire earlier on. This has a different suspension, a different rear end ratio. The car is significantly lighter than the V8 powered cars. Therefore, these actually were faster. Double step spoiler. So that's why you bought this car, because you wanted to go racing. And you can see, this one here is in awesome shape. It's got a freshly rebuilt engine, freshly rebuilt transmission. So you're getting a lot of the great things about it from the beginning here, as well as it's great looking and super, super rare. Anyway, circa 1985 paint. This is much nicer, as you can see. It's a mirror finish. You want to take this car to a show, because you know why you want to take it to a show? You're never going to see another one like it. There's 4 in the entire country or an entire world left. I don't know where they are, right? This could be the only one that you may ever see. There might be 3 left, 2 left. We don't really know that answer. This is kind of cool too. So this is a neat piece. They etched the VIN number into the glass so that people couldn't steal parts off of it. Because it was a rental car, even though it wasn't really a rental car, they rented it for shows. This right here was required so that people couldn't, you'll see all rental cars always have the VIN number etched on there. A couple things I wanted to point out differently is you get a different front fascia, you get the step spoiler back there. This one happens to have the sunroof, which is optional as well. And this car here was really not the sticker price, almost $16,000 in 1985. That's a lot of money, man. A Corvette was just a little bit more, and we're talking about a Mustang. A Mustang was down with the Camaros, where in the Corvettes were always 50% more than all of those. So this car was really expensive for its time, hence the reason why they didn't sell a whole lot of them. So, cool piece. All right, so let's take a peek under the hood and see what goes on when you're building a factory race car. All right? All right, so the engine itself right here, so they run it rated at 175 horsepower. Most people claim these make well over 200, closer to the V8 power of the 225. Intercooled, fuel injected, four-wheel disc brakes, power steering, which is fast ratio as well. But you also get some luxury stuff too. This still has air conditioning. And what I wanted to show you was, if this is the center line of the wheel, okay, you can see how far back the engine is, and that's what helps handling. A mid-engine car is always after the front wheel or before the rear wheels. This is very close to that, where the V8 car would have been come out all the way to there, and which would have been a much bigger hanging over the front end, therefore it didn't handle nearly as well. Regular Mustang GTs were not known for their handling because of that reason. These cars here were ready to race. All right, nice big aluminum radiator, electric fans, you know, all of the things that made for a fast car requiring less power from the engine, and the engine making all of that. A lot of people don't know that these cars had four-wheel disc brakes. They're buried inside those big wheels, and they look great. This is a real ram air scoop that goes right to the intercooler. You can look right inside there, and the intercooler is right in there. Just some cool pieces. All right, let's take a peek in the back of the trunk, because believe it or not, this car is usable. You go to a car show, you go to the beach, you can go do whatever you want with it, and I'm going to show you that right now. Okay, so come on in here for a second. This is crazy that this car is a race car, because people don't think about that, but they really are. They're built for that reason. The back seats fold down. You could use it. You could go someplace with somebody. Anyway, here's the Marty report here. I wanted to just show you that real quick. This comes framed. All right, you get that. Here's the original window price, $15,500. Look at the fuel economy, though. 26 miles to the gallon for a performance car, right? And then you have the breakdown in here, so the production numbers. This is kind of cool because it shows here sold to fleet, right? And then you have all of the options right here, okay? And here's the breakdown of how few there were. There's 10 of them painted dark sage, right? All right, so let's go check out the interior now and see what the cockpit looks like and where you'll be sitting. All right, so as we sit in this car, we're talking about a race car, and the reason why you know some of it is, first of all, it has a switch to tell you whether it'll change the spark advance, whether you're using premium fuel or you couldn't get it, because these were higher compression at a time, and they're turbos, so they need premium fuel because they get a lot of power out of them. The seats are awesome because they have all this lumbar support. You say, well, wow, that's, you get that today in today's modern car. You're right, but this is a 1985. We're doing this video in 2018. That was a long time ago, right? The seats themselves, the bladders pump up with this, and you let it out with this switch here. Built-in fog lamps, cassette, power windows, power lock, sunroof. Just a nicely done car. 8,000 RPM Tach, and it's pretty cool. I love it. And the stick is nice, man. It's right here in your hand. Works like a champ. And you're rolling on down the road. Hey, as we close up this video on this car, this potentially could be the rarest Mustang ever built during the 80s. We are talking about one of four left. Seriously, one of four left. I'm not sure where the other three are, but it's one of four left. It's in the registry. It says this is a rare car. This is a spectacular car, and it is an awesome car to drive, especially with all the great features, the race car parts, great power. I mean, it's cool, cool, cool. Anyway, call us 301-816-1000. We'll tell you all about this SVO race car. So I want to fire it up, and you say, well, if it's a four-cylinder, what can it sound like? Well, when it's a factory built by a special vehicle team's operation, four-cylinder, it sounds a lot different.